Sonic 1029.
Hello.
Hello.
Are we?
You guys are sideways somehow.
Wait, give us one sec. I bet if you
can. Yeah, for sure.
Hey.
There we go.
Is that okay?
Yeah, that works.
Okay, cool.
Hey, I'm Taylor, by the way. Nice to meet you guys.
How's it going? Adam, good. Jack, and I.
Hey.
You're in order. Do you always do that?
Always.
Yeah.
It just comes up that way.
Yeah, it just comes natural?
Yeah, it does.
That's why the band's AJR and not JAR.
It just happened.
We just looked and we were like, oh, we're standing in this order. We might as well call the band.
So yeah, what have you guys been doing during this pandemic? My wife and I, we just finished The Office for like the 18th time. So
Did you watch it all the way through, like even the last season, or did you stop?
Yeah, we even make it through the Andy years and it gets the
You made it through. That's the right word. Those are the right words to use.
Yeah.
but no, we've been writing a lot. Anyway, we weren't planning on it. Obviously, we're supposed to be on tour right now, you guys. We figured, you know, like if we have nothing else to do, then I guess we should just kind of throw ourselves into writing, which is not something we usually do. Whenever we write, it's always just if it comes to us, then we'll start. Like we're walking down the street and we get inspired, then we'll run home. It's never a let's sit down and write today. We literally never done that in 15 years. So yeah. We started doing it. Kind of really nervous that we would fail right away, but it actually really worked out. We've written actually a ton of songs so far, some of which are going to come out really soon.
Cool. It's a strange time, right? So do you feel like, even though you're going into this in a different way with more meaningful, active sitting down to write, do you feel like there's tons of stuff around that can just inspire you in different ways?
Yeah, I think that, everyone's asking, are we writing like coronavirus related songs, you know, in terms of like being quarantined and all that stuff. And I that definitely did come up. But when you're in the middle of, you know, anything that's difficult or, you know, anxiety inducing or emotional, it sort of brings up other things in your life that are a lot more personal. It sort of makes you could even think back to, oh, wow, when I was eight years old, this happened, or maybe I'm nervous for this part in my future. So that stuff just kind of comes up out of nowhere when you're in that mindset. So when that happens, we just kind of take it and run with it.
Yeah, you get the chance to kind of slow down and dig a little deeper into everything that's going on.
Right, yeah.
And I assume you guys are obviously inspired by a ton of different styles of music. One thing that's so great about AJR songs is there's all these different sounds, there's all these different layers, and you manage to get them all together in this great little package. Do you feel like there's more time to kind of explore and discover new styles of music these days?
Absolutely. I think especially with what we do, I guess the one thing I'll brag about us is I think we really delve into the most unknown areas of music in like history and bring it to the pop scene or the alternative scene, and it's music that no one would have any idea exists, but it's so catchy and like is clearly the beginning and like the genesis of what evolved to be pop today. So we kind of dug back to like, even for the last album for Neo Theater, we dug back to like the songs of like the 1920s and 30s, like Close Harmony Choir that like recorded for Disney movies. And they have just the most catchy chord progressions and catchy melodies ever. So we said, okay, let's kind of use this as sort of a template and try to make it pop and current.
Is there anything that's been coming up lately?
What have we been listening to
lately? A lot of Israeli music.
Yeah, Israeli production is, they really have their, they're really ahead of the moment.
I'm trying to think what else. I don't know. I think AJR, what I'm most proud of about AJR is our ability to kind of do a hybrid of like real organic orchestral music and then somehow make it sound modern and make it sound electronic. So I think we've been exploring a lot of that, of like, how do we take, a trumpet, a sound that everybody understands, and make it into something that sounds like a synthesizer or sounds like it could only be made in 2020. So I think we're exploring a lot of new tricks around that.
Totally. What is it about Israeli music that's been capturing you guys?
Oh God, they're, especially Israeli hip hop, the production, like modern Israeli hip hop, is really just forward thinking. It's
sort
like
no rules.
Yeah, it's like what was cool about the Travis Scott song, now I'm forgetting the name, Sicko Mode. What was what everyone freaked out about, that what it switches up tempo halfway through. They've been doing that for so long. They have like five switch ups in every song, of time signature, of tempo, of rhythm, of feel. And so it feels really cool to us to see like the extreme of what you can do with a song and then go from there.
Yeah. That's cool. And so just generally, you guys have kind of talked about this already, but what's it like being a band during a pandemic? I assume just your focus shifts so quickly and so much from being on tour to chilling out and working on new stuff? Was that a hard adjustment to make? Was it kind of welcome? How's that gone for you guys?
So yeah, touring is really interesting because while we love it, it's also kind of a job, and we've been doing it for 7 years now. We've been on the road. So what happens, like, the best part of the day, the most, like, the greatest part is the hour and a half that we're on stage. When we're not on stage, it's we wake up, like, a million interviews, sound check, rehearsal, this thing going over here to this. So it's like a real work day. Same with after the show too. So it kind of was nice to get, like, a little bit of a break. And now it's kind of the first time that I'm realizing in, like, a while since we've been touring constantly that I genuinely miss being on the road, not just, like, the performance aspect. I literally miss the difficult aspects as well.
It's one of those pauses that can give you a bit of perspective and an appreciation for stuff you're not doing, right?
It really has. I think that's, like, the biggest theme of this whole, like, coronavirus, this whole time. You're really thankful for everything you thought you hated.
It's cool because, like, the famous phrase, if you don't know what you got till it's gone,
exactly.
It's like a weird test drive for everybody. This is what the world would be like if you didn't have the stuff. Do you actually like the stuff that you have? It's pretty cool. It's a cool moment.
Yeah.
It's like, oh yeah, I remember hugs. Those were kind of cool.
Yeah, totally.
Okay, so now you guys are going to show us how you made Bang. This How We Made series on that you guys have been doing is so cool. I think it's because whenever you listen to an AJR song, you hear something more. You hear something different. You get deeper into it. So this deconstructing of a song, I think that's why it's so fascinating for so many people. All right, so from here, we'll move on into the How It's Made part.
Hello, we are AJR. Welcome to the making of Bang. So, with Bang, the main backbone of this record is this piano.
And I think that we want to do something really simplistic, which is not something we've ever really done with AJR music. You know, we always say, let's just go right in huge.
Right.
But we wanted something really matter-of-fact and to the point.
And so, what we like to do with AJR is we like to do this hybrid of real organic instruments and this kind of electronicness. So, we have this piano. And then we have this scoop, this pitch bend that you'll see here. As if you're turning your record player on really quickly. So you immediately realize, oh, okay, this isn't this acoustic song. It's going to be manipulating a little bit. I get down and I'm jumping around. And the romp is some rock. It's a comfortable night. Been a hell of a ride. But I'm thinking it's time to grow. And so here we have the main tag of the song, which we kind of think about as our Sweet Caroline, ba ba ba. We kind of, bang, bang, bang. And that's our neighbors, our dad,
anyone we could think of.
You can kind of hear our neighbor that's 3 years old. Bang. You hear him at the end.
Bang.
What else with this song? And then I guess the other big part of the song is the chorus, that massive orchestral, like almost evil Disney villain,
right.
Sound. And that was kind of the idea we were going for.
Here we go.
And so that has a lot of elements to it. It has all of these real orchestral instruments, like timpanis, this synthetic orchestra, some brass, and then we got some real trumpets as well. And it kind of all added up with these trap drums, with these rolling hi-hats, this kind of like rim click.
And then we thought that would sort of bring it into the 21st century.
Yeah, so it's this nice mix. And then the last thing I want to talk about is the Here We Go, that we touched on a little bit, but that sample here is the voice of the New York subway system. Hold on, I'm looking for the sound.
Here We Go, Metronome.
He has, like, the most incredible timbre to his voice. It's so basic.
Okay, and all of those elements added up to Bang. Bang, bang, bang.
Here we go.